after play. We're going to have a reception in the new lodge, which is upstairs. Hopefully some of you have gotten bruised through there on your way down here. Afterwards, it's going to behoove you to head that way and partake in some refreshments. Historic match once a year here at the golf club. Actually, this will be the first match we play on the newly redesigned lakeside court. Bob Cup, golf course architect, with a lot of help from our course owner, Mr. Ben Kenny, has made Lakeside very nice. I think you two guys are going to enjoy it. So for those who do not know, we have the reigning U.S. Amateur Champion and the reigning British Amateur Champion playing a head-to-head match. Today, I will introduce Bryson DeChambeau, who is one of the things reigning U.S. Amateur Champion. Future career looks to be real good. He actually plays out of Dragonfly Golf Club in California, Phobos, California, and we welcome you to the golf club. Secondly, from all the way from France, welcome. Thank you for coming this whole way. Ramon Longas, playing out of Saint-Bernard, out of Grasse, born and raised in Calvary, France. Our honorary captain, Bob Cup, he will actually be reception afterwards, and probably love to hear what you think about the lakeside course. Hello, Mr. Gump. Good to see you. It's okay with the advice, and I'll flip the coin and allow Ramon to continue. We got heads or tails? Heads, cup logo, tails. You like the logo?
Yes.
Tails or blank. Bryson. Right. You may choose.
I guess I'll go first.
Thank you. This is an eagle putt to win the hole. It's a decent go of a birdie putt. Forthcoming at the par 5. Cindy Shingo for birdie. This is now a birdie putt to win the hole for Roman Langosk. And he takes a 1-up lead through one. Decent little second shot here at the second. Not a bad shot. Now Roman's approach has an early 1-up lead over DeChambeau. For a moment here to second. That would have been for back-to-back birdies. Cindy Shambo is a birdie putt to win the hole and square the match. And a part putt to have the hole for a moment. And through two holes, he remains 1-up over DeChambeau. birdie putt in the hole, move two up. He should go down for par to stay one down. And Roman keeps one up lead through three. December second shot to the fourth. Gas comes up in the hole and go two up. This is a birdie putt. Going right at it.
Here it comes.
Come on, second shot in the air. Inside of Bryson. Liam Gaskin lost the fifth hole, so this match is on square. This is Bryson DeChambeau's second shot here at par 3-6. Nice and decent, but only half the hole. And the match remains on square through six. Second shot for Ramon here at the 381 meter par 4 7th. Good shot. Now Bryson's approach. There's only been one birdie in this match so far, and that was from Len Gaskbeck at the opening hole. Ramon for birdie to win the hole here at 7. Second hole in a row, he has just missed the birdie putt. Once again, DeChambeau for par to have the hole. He's made them all so far. Comes through clutch again. Match remains all square through 7. Bryson DeChambeau is now one up. This one fixes brakes in here at the par 5 ninth. This is his third shot. One up in his match. That doesn't even get to the green. Two putts for Langas to win the hole. That was an eagle putt. This birdie putt is conceded. It may be out to the right. Yards. Third shot for William Gask. And 11. So birdie putt to win the hole and go 3 up. So Bryson will now have another par putt to half the hole.
Chambeau 6. My gas is 2 up.
Three up through 13.
Langasse 2, DeChambeau 3. Langasse is 3 up.
Nice shot. Shot.
Very pretty there.
Good eye. Very nice.
That was to go 4 up. DeChambeau's lost a 9th, 10th, 11th. And 13th holes, 4 to last 5, to go from 1 up to 3 down, is going to lose this hole. So 3 down with 4 to go.
DeChambeau 4, Langasse 4, Langasse remains 3 up.
Langasse for a birdie to move hole and the match. And Langasse defeats DeChambeau 4 and 3. He is your 2016 Georgia Cup champion. DeChambeau was 1 up after 8. And then line gas 1, 9, 10, 11, 13, and 15 to win the match.
So you know they're probably going to yell out. we don't end up flipping a coin. It depends who I get to talk to first. But what's important here is that you have a chance to hear from the people who are actually in a tremendous transitional state. Because when you win at their level, the world recognizes you. So, and I only want to ask one question of each, which will probably turn into quite a bit more information. But since you were the winner today, I would like to ask you a very simple question. You won the British Hammer. And you can tell us what happened directly after that, or anything else you would like to tell us about winning the British Hammer.
Hello. Winning the British Hammer was just amazing for me. It was, I think, the best way to finish a career amateur because you have invitation for the British Open, for the Masters, and for the US Open. I just didn't realize when I won it on the green. I was just so happy, and my family was with me. And it was one of the best moments I got in my career for the moment. You just think, whoa, now there is a lot of singer right to you. You have a lot of new friends. A lot of people send you message. You don't know why, but that's fun. You receive invitation, you receive sponsor, you receive a lot of things, and it was a lot in a few days. So I just tried to put myself on the golf, my father, my mother, my family, do everything else, and just me concentrate on my golf. Then, after when I played the British Open, I didn't realize I will play the British Open. I just realized when I was on the first tee and I was like that. The fairway was like 80 meters and I was with my fireman. So I just try to have fun all the time and to stay concentrated on my golf and not on the people around me, on the sponsor, on the money, on everything, just to play golf to have fun and to enjoy every moment. So that's it.
Imagine what it'd be like, you see the story of winning the British Open, and then coming to grips with the fact that within a month you'd been playing the Open Championship at the Old Course. That's so special. All of that. There's something they have in common. They're both going to play. Next week. The little tournament we have down the road. That's just one more theme that their accomplishment is brought to. As you mentioned too, there are very special attributes. Obviously, he wasn't born speaking English. And of course, the game is going to take him places where he goes. But like many European athletes, he's multilingual. That's not just something everybody has an education trying to learn any Spanish. On this side, the character that speaks in languages that none of us understand as a physics major, but he's been written up in the magazines and so on, and he has an unusual philosophy. But all of this stuff, which tells you that he's marching to a particular place, not one that we all know well. So, having said that, I would like to ask you, not necessarily what it meant to win the Emmy, what it does, and this is probably for both of you, what it does to your entire lives as you move forward now, the changes you're going to be making, so on and so forth.
Yeah.
So I think it would be great if we could hear you as well.
Thank you, first off. And then another first off, congratulations to you. What an incredible day. It's been awesome. Done a great job, and food's been incredible. Hospitality's been awesome. So thank you. Well, also the membership here, all the guys coming out and supporting us playing a nice little friendly competitive match. Thank you for coming out. It's funny. I guess it's definitely a life changer. You know, one funny little story that I want to tell, and it comes about my caddy. Who's at the U.S. Handicap for me is right here, Mike Shy. He's done an incredible job. He's like my second father. Just been an amazing person in my life. I definitely couldn't be here without him. But quite a funny thing was that whole week we were kind of struggling early in the week and wasn't really hitting it that great. And just kind of going through the motions and switching a couple things, the driver, and I think it was like 4 degrees in the left right or something like that. And so it's kind of a weird week to start off already, and didn't really expect too much. Went out the first round, played okay, shot even. Played the second round, shot even too, not too bad. In that second round, though, we had a little bit of a kerfuffle, I guess you could say. There was a two-shot penalty given to me because I was late to the tee time. And yeah, thanks, Mike. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. It was partly my fault, but then also it was trouble on the USGA's, and they gave me a wrong tee time sheet, I think it was. Is that better? They gave me a wrong tee time sheet, and ultimately the penalty was taken back. But that's not even the story. The funny part of the story is that this whole week, we didn't really expect anything. The only thing we were expecting is that we were to win, that I would not turn professional, wait to turn professional until after the Masters, but if I lost, then I would actually turn professional right after the Walker Cup. And that was a big week for me because I want to play the Masters, obviously. And so go through the motions, go to, let's see, beat Paul Dunn in the semifinals, quarterfinals, excuse me. And I play Sean Conner in the semifinals. And what a day that was. That was really interesting, and he was a great competitor, too. And got to the 15th hole, and I had this wedge. They moved the tee box up at Olympia Fields. And it's a 120-yard shot, and it usually is around 165, 170 yards. So they moved it up, had a wedge in hand. I was 4 up going through the last several holes, dormy, and Sean Crocker, and I actually hit a decent shot, wedge shot from the green, and it's front right. Difficult little pin location, and Sean hits it up there, actually right next to the hole, and spins it back all the way off the front of the green. He's got like 35 feet or something like that. I've got 24 feet. So it was looking pretty good for me to just hopefully he misses two putt and move on. And so he actually gets his putt up to about a foot away, and I give it to him, and I'm looking over this putt, and for the first time, I realized that I have 2 putts to go to the Masters. And that was the first time it really hit me, and I was kind of shocked. It threw me back. I lost my train of thought. So what am I doing? What am I going to do? So I go around to read it, and I, you know, we bring Mike in a little bit. We talk about the pot going up the hill, going down just a little bit at the end, 3 feet. I hit this 24-footer, and it ends up being about a foot and a half, 2 feet short almost, and go up there and look over at Sean. He doesn't give it to me, so I mark it. Pick it up. Okay, well now I got a 2-footer to go to the Masters, you know? And so I give it to Mike, and he cleans the ball a little bit again, but you know me, I clean the ball, it's fresh, but whatever, it's just kind of a routine. And so then I get back to the ball, and he gives me the ball back right in the middle of the 2-footer. And I kind of look at him and go, well, what do you think? And he didn't say one word, he stumbled, because he didn't realize that 2 foot was to go to the Masters. So it was a funny little thing, and I'm like, Mike, you okay? Left center, dude, just hit it. So I get this putt down, and knock it in dead in the middle of the heart, go over and shake John Crocker's hand. And the first thing that me and Mike did when we hugged, you know, usually you say congratulations, but now he said we're broke for another year. Transition's a lot of fun. It's one that's more difficult than people think. But again, it's one that is something that I'll never forget. So again, thank you to my family, my friends, and team. It's done a great job, and looking forward to the Masters. Played, I think, almost 10 rounds there now. So really looking forward to doing my best out there. Got to get some things squared away first off. But this journey's been a lot of fun, and thank you all for the support coming out today and giving your best for us. So thank you.
I'm not sure what the drill is now, but I think something questions and answers. Could we take a couple? Does anybody have secret, hidden questions that you'd love to ask somebody like these two guys? Speak up. But are there any questions of them about him? Thanks, everybody.